This video will walk through exercise 6A step by step. The goal of this exercise is to build out a body of a batch request to return each of the system endpoints in one request. We're going to go through three different ways to do this. The first way we'll show is by explicitly specifying each system endpoint in its own subrequest. The only thing that is not finished for this one is the endpoint, which is just batch. Even though our requests are all read-only, our verb for any batch request needs to be post. We can see the results of each subrequest is returned in the response body. For the second method, we're going to get the default endpoint and use the links provided in that response as parameters for the other queries. We can use the JSON path syntax to define each parameter that we want to put into the resource field. We need to specify which parent IDs must execute before a child requests can execute. Since the last six requests use the results of the getSystemLanding subrequest, we need to specify that in the parent IDs field to ensure that request executes first and those results are available for the subsequent requests. The final method is described in the bonus section. We will substitute one request template for the six child requests that were used in the previous method. A request template will allow you to take any parameter that is array, in this case the links given by the getSystemLanding request, and substitute each array value into the defined placeholder. So for this example, each of our links will go directly in the resource field and will result in the generation of six subrequests. Request templates are concise and useful in many situations. For example, if you do not know how many results a parent request will return beforehand.